Welcome. My name is Ton de Jong. I'm from the University of Twente in the Netherlands. And in this short video, I'd like to argue why, if you are using inquiry-based science education in your class, GoLab is an ecosystem that you should consider using for that. Suppose that you like your students to become engaged learners by means of inquiry, because you realize that if they use inquiry, they learn deeper, they acquire deeper conceptual knowledge, and they are also more motivated to learn science topics. If you think that online laboratories, and more in general online teaching, is the way to go, and you also know that you need to support your students in the inquiry process, then you should really consider using the GoLab ecosystem for your instructional goals. What GoLab offers, in short, is that GoLab offers the world's largest collection of online laboratories in one portal. And we are very grateful to our colleagues from all around the world that they are sharing their laboratories on the GoLab website. GoLab also offers a unique set of apps to support students in the inquiry process in the first place, but also in acquiring 21st century skills such as collaboration, reflection, and assessment. GoLab also offers authoring facilities to make learning experiences for your students as you like them to be. You can configure, you can make them bring things together. It's what you like your students to offer. There's also a community platform to exchange information, to share products with other teachers all around the world. And altogether, there's also a unique set of tutoring facilities for teachers helping you to design effective inquiry learning spaces. Let's start with the online laboratories. What GoLab offer you is online laboratories from all around the world. At the moment, we do have more than 600 online laboratories available for you. These can be virtual laboratories, data sets, or remote laboratories. And they come in a large diversity. There are many subject domains that we cover. We are covering all big ideas of science. The age ranges are from before 7 until above 16. We have remote labs, virtual labs, and data sets. And the number of languages is enormous. Altogether, these labs are on the GoLab ecosystem. You can find them on www.golabs.eu. Secondly, we offer a unique set of apps. And apps are little tools, or you might call them scaffolds, that enable students to perform a task that they could not do without the scaffold. And the scaffolds are, the apps are designed in such a way that they help students to overcome difficulties that they experience. And they have the idea of fading, which means that you start with an extensive app, but you gradually can leave that app out of the learning environment so that students can learn on their own. So it's like with the bike that you see here. First you have the side wheels, and then as a father, and I have a lot of experience with that, you run behind the bike until you let your kid go loose on the bike on his own, on his or her own. I only have sons. The inquiry apps we have, they cover the inquiry cycle as we have designed them this in the project. The inquiry cycle does cover a number of stages, such as orientation, where students try to get a feeling for the domain, a phase where they, what we call conceptualization, where they design a question or they generate a hypothesis, then they do investigation, then they move to a conclusion, and in the discussion phase, they do communication or reflection. So they communicate their results to their peer students or they reflect on their own learning process. And in GoLab, we have more than 40 apps altogether, and every phase of the inquiry cycle is covered by the app. So in every inquiry cycle, you can use an app that helps the students to do an effective inquiry process. As an example, here you have an example of the experiment design tool that helps students to design experiments by giving them properties and measures and ways to combine them to complete experiments where they indicate which properties they want to vary, which one they have to keep constant, and which measures they want to take. And for every app in GoLab, there are ways for you to customize that app to your own domain, to your own taste, and for your own students. So these are the apps that help the students to perform an effective inquiry learning process. But we also have apps that help the students to do 21st century skills, to acquire 21st century skills. We have apps that teach the students and help them in an effective collaboration process. We have apps that help the students to do reflection. And we have apps that help students to assess other students and being assessed by other students. Well, let's focus on the reflection ones. We have a number of reflection apps for the students available, where they see which time they have spent, which activities they have done, how they have created a concept map in relation to concept map of other students, et cetera, et cetera. And for each of the apps, there is a teacher view and a student view. In the teacher view, you see the names of all the students so that you know which student has done what. In the student view, the student only sees his or her own name and the other students are anonymous. Let's give you an example. Here we have a reflection example where the student sees the activities that he or she has done in the inquiry process. The student also sees the average activity level of the other students. And then there are some reflection questions where students can indicate how their activity compares to the activity of the other students and why they were more active, less active, or at the same level. Now, if you want to bring that all together, so you have online laboratories, you have inquiry apps, you have 21st century apps, you have other multimedia material, you want your students to have a full learning experience. And GoLab offers you the possibility to create these full learning experiences for students. And we call that inquiry learning spaces. So here you see a few snapshots of inquiry learning spaces where on the top in the blue, you do see the inquiry cycle and of course adapted and renamed by the teacher, so configured by the teacher who made this inquiry learning space, him or herself. Here you see another example where it starts with what do we want to find out, etc., etc. And a final example about humans and bees, again, to give you a flavor of what an inquiry learning space looks like. To create those inquiry learning spaces yourself, we offer a very easy to use and straightforward authoring environment that is also called GRASP. Here you see a screen dump of the authoring environment where you see the different phases like orientation, conceptualization, investigation. And basically what you have to do is to fill each of these phases with a lab, with multimedia material, with your own text, and with the apps that we offer to you. And here you can see how you can add an app to an inquiry learning space. You simply go to a drop-down menu. You select the app that you want to include at that point in time, and then you have to configure that app to your own taste and needs. When you have done so, you simply click on one button, you get a URL that you give to your students, and your students can work with the ILS as we have seen it a few slides ago. In GoLab, that's the main thing that we offer in GoLab. We offer you the labs, we offer you the apps, and we offer you the authoring environment to put that together with all kinds of other multimedia material that you like to use. But in GoLab, you're also member part of a community. If you are creating an ILS, and here you see a snapshot of GRASP again, you can add fellow teachers, you can make them members of your ILS. So you can together create an inquiry learning space. Once you have created an inquiry learning space that you think is worth sharing, you can offer it for being published at GoLabs. At the moment, we do have close to 1,000 ILSs, inquiry learning spaces, published on GoLabs. And you can use that ILS and reuse it, adapt it, and use it for your own students. And here you see a few examples of those ILSs in many different languages shared at www.golabs.eu. The GoLab community, finally, is a kind of space where you can subscribe to, where you can see all kinds of events, communicate with your fellow teachers, and be part of that GoLab international community. A final reason to use GoLab is that GoLab doesn't let you find it out all on yourself. There are many tutoring facilities in GoLab. We have the GoLab support pages, where you can find videos, tips and tricks, brief guides, etc., both on inquiry learning, how to design inquiry learning spaces, and on the technologies of the GoLab ecosystem. And there is much, much more to offer in GoLab. For example, you can inspect the work of each individual student in the authoring environment. So you can look at all the things that your students have been doing in order to give them individual feedback. You can make ILSs in your own language. We have many, many languages available at the moment. You are not restricted to the GoLab apps. You can also include third-party apps in your inquiry learning space. You can use ILSs in a flipping the classroom setting. We offer you tools in which you can see all the behavior of your students, and you can use that as an input when your students come back and have done an experiment at home. You can use that as a starting point for your lesson in the class. We offer different inquiry scenarios. You just have seen the basic scenario that we have all the time, but there are more complicated and more dedicated scenarios that you can use as a starting point. And there's also, for example, an app with which you can give individual feedback to each student. And there's much, much more. So I'd like to encourage you to have a look at www.golabs.eu. Find a lab that suits your class. Try to create your own inquiry learning space. Maybe do that together with colleagues. And if you're very successful, also offer that one for sharing that with the international community of science teachers using GoLab at the moment.